Alex and Jason here. We're running our weekly recap, having a little fun at Friday night here. It is Neil deGrasse Tyson's birthday, so I'm rocking my Neil shirt. Awesome. So, we have been working on this week, getting out of some of all those positions we got into last week. The knee on belly, the S mount, some of these difficult mounts to escape. And tonight we're going to kind of recap how to get out of that, stop that knee on belly position. So, as I go down, it's always easier to stop this motion early than later. So one of the things I like to do is, if you notice, as I'm running my defensive position, this isn't just keeping him from mount. This knee is in his hip. It's feeling what he's doing. That's giving me a little bit of an early warning as to what his hips are doing, and that lets me get ahead of this decision-making process. The next thing I like to do is take this hand, I'm going to bridge a little and get it under his armpit. Even if I can't get a full underhook, I want this hand sitting here for purposes of the drill tonight. So, as he postures up, rather than let him get to a full knee on belly, I'm driving this leg up. You can see how I'm even activating this leg. I'm driving this leg up, my elbow's coming in, this hand that was in the underhook stands by, and now I've made a wall. So if Jason jumps out for a second, you can see how I've built this wall that's preventing him from taking knee on belly. So when Jason comes back in, I'm not fighting that constrictive pressure on my diaphragm. I'm right here, and it's always easier to defend early. So to reorient myself to where I can start to attack again, I'm going to use my bottom foot, and I'm going to bring it out, and I'm going to shimmy my hips right to the side to start getting that weight off me. Once I've shimmied, I'm shrimping, and I'm getting to my side. And look where I'm bringing my shin as I come to the side. I'm protecting the hip, and I'm getting that wall between me and him. My hands are still up in case he knee slides, and I'm building that connection. From here, this hand is hooking the ankle, low on the ankle. For some reason, the higher I get, the easier it is for him to get out of this, so I'm hooking low. Now, this arm is driving, and I'm using this momentum of my shoulders coming up to augment what my legs are going to do. And my legs are going to do a scissor and turn my hips toward the ground. I'm reaching with this, I'm wrapping the leg, and I'm letting that momentum carry me to my knees. Now, my shoulder is going to go below his knee, because I don't want to be up here where I don't have an effective lever on the knee and where he can start grabbing the guillotine. I want low. So as soon as my shoulder hits, I'm even going to slide a little lower. Now I feel his shin in my ear. I'm just going to drive in the direction of the leg and affect my takedown. So, quick recap. Prevention always easier than actually beating that full, set in, pressurized diaphragm in the knee and belly position. Work your hips. Use that momentum in your hip turn to conduct the escape, not your arm pull. So, that's our review for the week. We'll be back next week with more stuff. Guys, see you later.